Hi guys, this is Imaneo, welcome to my channel. In this series we are implementing a color switch game replica using Flutter and Flame game engine, and in this episode we are going to implement a pause and resume functionality, and also we are going to get familiar with Flame decorators to make a blur effect when you see the pause overlay. So let's jump into the code. At first, let's take a look at the latest state of the game. We have a player which jumps if you tap the screen, and if you hit with the wrong color you lose. For example, yeah, it is working well. So today we are going to add a pause button here to add pause and resume functionality. At first we need to restructure the widget tree that we have. As you see, we have a full screen widget which we are passing to the run app function. I'm going to cut this code, and instead we are going to have a material app, and home is a home page. And here we are going to have a scaffold, and body is a stack widget. And the first child is the game behind everything. And on top of that, we are going to have an align widget. With top left alignment, and child is an icon button with pause icon, and onPress is an empty function for now. So if I run the app, yeah, as you see we have a pause button here, so it is black. To make it white, we are going to change the application theme. We are going to use theme data dot dark. So this way we are going to have light overlays because our game is a dark game, dark background game. Yes, this is the pause button. And now we are going to add some functions into the game class. We are going to add a pause game resume game and yes, we are going to fill these methods and getters later. We have a pause game, resume game, and is game pause getter. So here we can say if, at first let's get a reference from this my game. We are going to convert it to a stateful widget. We are going to have an instance of my game, and in init state we are going to initialize this variable. Okay, and here we can pass the instance that we created, and here we can say if game is paused, we are going to show play arrow, otherwise we are going to show pause icon. And here we can say if game is paused, we are going to say resume game, and otherwise we are going to say my game dot pause game. Okay, yes, because it is returning true. If we change it to false, it is a pause button. So we can implement these functions we have a pause engine function, which is in the Flame Game class. You can use these two methods to pause and resume the game. So we are going to call them simply and here we can say, I think there is a getter called paused. Yes, it is defined in the game. And if you run the app, yes, game is paused, but it is not resuming. At first, let me add a set state here to update the button state here. Okay, and when game is not paused, oh, if game is paused, resume game, otherwise pause game. Oh, we are adding a recursive method here. Okay, now it works well. So, yeah. And when game is paused, we can add some overlays, text, or maybe a larger play button in the middle of a screen. For example, we can say we want to have a column, a normal Flutter column. And we are going to say, wrap it to the center. And we are going to have a text which says paused with a large text style. Color is colors.white, font size is something like 48, font weight is bold. And if I run the app, as you see, it is showing there. We are going to add an if statement to say if game is paused, we need to render this column. And when you play, it disappears. And when you pause the game, it appears. We are going to change the alignment here. Okay, so we are going to add a button here. I'm going to add a larger play button here. For example, we can say this is an icon button. Okay, and let's remove this const keyword. Yes, it is a small, let's increase the size. Is good, I think. Maybe 140. Yes. So this way, we don't need this button here. We can say we only need the pause icon here. And let's put an if statement here. If game is not paused, or let's create a new one, is game playing is not off, is game paused. And here we can say if game is playing, we need to render this one. If game is paused, we need to render this one. And here we can just pause the game. And here we only need to resume the game. So we put it in the set state. Okay, this is the functionality that we want. And the next step is, you know, we can put overlay behind this pause menu. For example, we can say a container black of, for example, 45 maybe, to add a dark background to increase the contrast for showing these elements. But I'm going to add another thing here to blur the game. You know, we have a game here, and I'm going to blur every component of the game to have a better UI here. To do that, I'm going to explain a concept from Flame Game Engine. It is decorators. So decorator is a visual effect that you can apply it in your component in the Flame Game Engine. For example, we have blur effect. You can play around with the samples. For example, as you see, it is a normal component and you can add blur to the component. For example, this is a vertical blur. You can add something like 1 or 2 in X blurness and a much higher value for the Y value, for example, 7, 8, or 10. And you will get this effect. Also here we have grayscale effect decorator. You can add different, add a grayscale with different opacity. And also we have tint here. You can change the color of your component in the game and other stuff. So we are going to use a blur here. So to use that, we need to add this mixing as decorator. And when you add this mixing, you have access to a decorator property, which is null by default. And you can change the decorators. For example, you can have a blur decorator and you can chain it with a grayscale decorator. So position component has a decorator by default. So you can replace it with your own decorator to do some crazy things for drawing the shape, or you can chain your new decorator to the current decorator that position component has. For example, it draws the shape in a normal way, and you can add a blur effect to make it blur. Let's check into it in the code. For example, in our player, we have a decorator here. If you see, it is a variable in position component. And you can say at last, let's copy paste this code. Okay, as you see, our player is blurred. It is a cool effect. You can use it in your game, and you can define a Y value, for example, 20, to see a vertical blur. Yeah, it's really hard to play in this case. It makes it challenging. Yes, this is the concept of decorators. And if you want to chain the decorators, you can call addLast again, and you can add any other decorators you want here, and it chains the other decorators to apply all of them together. So let me remove these two because we are going to apply blurness to the whole game. So to do that, we need to, as you remember, our game is a most top component in the Flame component system. So if you apply a decorator, it applies to the all children and descendants. If we add the blur effect or blur decorator here, it applies to all the components in the game. Here we don't have the decorator by default. We need to add the mixing that we saw here as decorator. And if you add this decorator, as you see, you will have access to a decorator property. And for example, in onload, you can say decorator is a blur decorator. And let me import it. If you run the game, as you see, everything is blurred. And for example, what if we say 8, it's better. And we are going to use this blurness variable to add the blurness when we pause and remove the blurness when we resume the game. So at first it is 0, and we can change the blurness value in the pause and resume methods. So let's copy paste this code. And instead of creating a new paint decorator, let's use the same decorator that we have created in the onload method. Yes, we can say 10, for example, and when we resume the game, we can say 0. And if you run the app, yes, there is no blur effect here. This is because when you pause the engine, it is not going to call any update or render methods anymore. So everything is paused, and this effect will not going to be applied. To fix that, I have a solution in my mind. I don't know whether it is the best solution or not, but I'm going to explain it to you. We have a time scale property here. You can add this mixing to your game or any component that you want, and then you will have access to a time scale variable, and it determines how fast your game should go. And when you, for example, pass 2 here, it means that game runs with twice the speed. And also, for example, if you pass half or 0.5, it means that game is slower, twice as slower as normal speed. So let's use it here. We can add it in the game as time scale. And here, instead of calling pause engine and resume engine, I'm going to say time scale is 0, which means everything should go with 0 speed. I think still we have update and render methods, but they are not going to be called every frame because speed is 0, but we will have our effect here. When we resume the game, we change it to 1. And here we can say if time scale is 0, it means that game is paused. And if I run the app, yes, as you see, we have the blur effect under the pause overlay. So let me remove this code. For example, if I pass 2, let me check it when we pause and resume. As you see, everything is going twice as fast as the normal speed. Or if you pass half, everything is slow. So you can use this time scale property whenever you want to add a slow motion effect or something like that in the game. All right, I think we are done with this episode. We implemented pause and resume functionalities. And thanks for watching this video. If you like it, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel, and see you next time. Bye bye.